Oh, we're live.
Oh, hello everyone and welcome to Try It Tuesday. Cherry here with Kelly. Yay! Today we are going to be experimenting with upcycling your children's genes. Mm-hmm. I'm all about taking something and repurposing it, even if it's, you know, if it's a little too short, you can cut the leg off, you can do all sorts of stuff. And like Kelly has over here, show them your cutoffs. And I'm a very, very thrifty person, so if I can take a plain pair of jeans like this and turn them into something like this for my little girl. Can you see that, Kendra? I don't know where to place these because
they're so good. Tall. Yeah, we can put them down too even a little bit.
So taking a pair of just regular jeans and repurposing them to make them looking, you know, like they're a designer brand or something. I know my little girl just fell in love with these and can't wait till her waist is big enough to wear them. Maybe I should put a dart in them. They've only been a year, right? So we are going to be using the Rose Creation dye today, and we're going to be die cutting some wool felt. Wool felt works better than any of the other felts out there because when you put it on the dye, it doesn't stretch. Your everyday felt that you buy in the stores is very pliable and it isn't as thick and heavy, so it actually pulls when you put it over the dye.
I need to stop you guys for a second. For some weird reason, we're not seeing you from the wide camera up here.
We're only seeing
the what you put on the table.
And that it's me. It's my fault. I was thinking we might be able to view the big... My fault. I was thinking we'd be able to view our hands on the big screen, but apparently
we can't.
We all just have to squint at the tiny little box.
Okay.
Sorry. So. Welcome to Try It Tuesday.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some wool felt, and I'm going to... just cut it with my scissors, and I'm going to die cut it, and you're going to see just how easy this wool felt cuts with the dyes in the grand caliber.
I just realized, too, I was showing my cutoff jeans to nobody. So, yeah, so we're just having regular regular denim jeans, and Terry is showing us how to embellish them. So now...
dyes good. With this, and I'm just going to run it through the machine. Have any of you out there watching repurposed any pairs of jeans or purses or anything like that, canvas bags, anything? Let us know, and if you have, post them on our Facebook page. We would love to see what you've come up with. I just like to dabble and play, and that's what we're doing today. Do you see how easy that wool felt cuts with that? I mean, one pass and it's all done.
Let's get a good shot of that. I mean, that's super easy.
It's very, very, very easy to cut wool felt. So, now I've done that, I'm going to kind of just take this, move the crank caliber. And I've actually already started stitching. Can you see that?
Yeah.
I took one of the leaves, and I've already stitched it on the pair of jeans. And now I'm going to, I like to color coordinate things. So I'm going to take this flower. I already cut this one out. And what this is going to look like when it's all done is I'm going to have just, you know, a little bit of here. And have this one down here. And if you are going to be doing this, I would suggest that I like to hand wash Leandra's jeans after this, only because, I mean, everything's stitched on, but, you know, when it gets in there and ruffles with the other clothes and all that, it tends to loosen things up. So I will obviously be hand stitching this and then hand washing it. So it's all good. So I'm going to go ahead and stitch this flower on, Kelly, if you want to dabble with what you're going to be doing.
Oh, it is a complete dabble. This is like, this morning I'm
try
like,
try it Tuesday.
Do you think this might So we're going to completely play. Excuse me one moment. I have to stand up and grab it in. Oh, a raspberry plate. That's what I'm missing. Oh. I'm missing a raspberry plate. Let me think here.
I know there's one on Krista's desk out there.
So Terry, you stitch for one second.
Okay, I'm going to stitch.
Terry's going to stitch, and I'm going to return in one moment.
So how many of you, like me, have a plethora of embroidery thread just sitting around because you used to love to embroider, which I still do. I just don't have that kind of time now. And it's just sitting there doing nothing but, you know, sitting there. So I, actually, this is really embarrassing. I bought this thread probably 10 years ago when a store closed down in Wyoming. And I got the skeins for a penny a skein. And I think I bought everything the lady had. So I am finally using that stash of embroidery thread, which is great. So be honest, how many of you out there have your own little collection of embroidery thread just sitting there? Well, okay. Now you have no excuse.
Since I don't do this all the time, Terry, remind me of the embossing folder sandwich.
That's cracked.
Well, I'll pretend it's not.
Okay. put it on your base plate.
Base plate.
With the
raspberry plate. Yeah.
Sandwich.
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 So I'm going to take my jeans. They're just plain on the front. And I'm going to attempt to print on them. I know I'm crazy. Terry actually had given me this idea as we were bouncing around ideas. And we're like, I wonder if that would work. So this morning I'm like, hey, are we going to do that print? She's like, no. But we're going to try it anyway. So I have this.
Kelly's going to try it.
I'm going to try it because it's okay if I'm a complete failure. This is one of our new releases, and I'm so unprepared this morning, but it's got roses on it. I'm going to hold it down here so you can see. It has large roses on one side, and it has small roses on the other side. I'm going to use the large rose side, I think. And what I'm going to do is I have some fabric paint that we used on one of our other episodes where we were screen printing, and that was something we had never done before either. And it actually turned out really cute.
Yeah.
We used pantyhose and
pantyhose.
Embroidery hoops, and we had a stencil that we created using die cuts, and we painted. Oh, it's great. You'll have to look it up. It's on YouTube for all of your YouTubing needs. So I'm going to take my paint, and I'm going to paint my embroidery, or my embroidery folder, my embossing folder. And you want to put it on there, I think, pretty thick. I wish I had a better brush, too. But this was literally, like, as I sat down, I'm like, let's totally do this. So I'm painting it on all over. I need some more. You want it to be wet. This is so professional. This is why I do social media, because this is how my projects turn out. You know what? This is going to be probably the best project I've ever done, and everybody's gonna be like, yay!
Everybody's holding their breath. That's what Bear Bell told us to hold our breath. We're trying to see, is it going to work, Kelly? Is it going to work?
I don't know.
We'll see what happens.
We'll see. I am literally painting the embossing folder right now. Painty, 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 painty.
And Terry, I want you to know that you are not alone in your embroidery Woo-hoo! Obsession. Shirley says she has more than enough for everybody.
I'm right there with you, Shirley. I think if I bought another skein, my husband would probably flip out.
Yeah.
I just hide them from him. He doesn't really know how many things of floss I have.
And even Chris, who's on our, from our design team, she was saying that she doesn't embroider, but she has a ton of thread. So I don't know what she's doing with all the thread, but.
So I'm going to take my wet folder. I'm going to just kind of stick it in the leg, I think. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm just making this up as I go along.
There ain't nothing wrong with that.
That's crafting. That sounds like crafting.
I'm gonna sandwich up the leg in my folder. Are you excited?
You are being inspired right now. That's what's happening.
I'm just trying to figure out now how I'm going to get one leg through the machine.
Roll it halfway through and halfway out.
Okay.
That will work.
And I'm going to take my sort of broken thing, or not telling anyone that I'm doing that. Don't tell.
Don't tell.
Here we go.
They'll see it later.
Here we go.
Are you excited? I'm totally, like, freaking out right now.
We're standing by, Kelly.
Bated breath.
Okay. Oh my gosh, it's actually kind of really cool. If I could get better control on this, you would be like, that is really...
You can definitely see it really well.
Oh, yeah, and it even embossed it. That's what's kind of cool. Now, if you heat set that, Kelly, it would probably even be... Until you wash it, and then it would go away. But you could go in there and stitch it and highlight that, and that would be really cool.
You could probably, like, brush glitter over where it's embossed now, too. And
Oh, yeah.
But how funky is that? Like, now I want to, because I'm a seamstress. I don't think anybody knows that, really, but I am a seamstress. I used to design my own line of children's clothing, and this makes me want to go and, like, make it, like, a funky little patch now and put some glitter and some buttons and some splat. Now I want to do, like, splatter paint on this side, like, maybe I'll do that.
Yeah, there you go. You should do it.
Maybe I'll just finish my little painty pants, and you would have your little embroidery pants.
Your little painty pants.
Painty nice. Pants and embroidery pants.
New term.
Painty pants.
You learn something new every day.
Yes, you do.
So if I'm like, oh, fabric paint doesn't flick very well. I have to use my fingers, I think.
Dab, dab, you know, it all works, right?
This is fun.
You're doing something that's fast and furious, and mine is very tedious.
Kelly, do me a favor. Could you put the pants back in the shot one more time? I could see it from here, but for some reason they weren't able to see it.
Sure. Ta-da. So you clicked over into the small window?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's it. Those are the pants. And now I'm adding random bits of flair.
Stop.
Random bits of flair to my pants. Maybe they should be swirls.
Well, at that point, you can do just about anything you want to, right?
Yeah. This is fun. Like, I want to do this to my own pants now. My pants that I would probably never wear.
Probably.
But it's fun to think about.
Yeah.
I bet Fair Belle would wear them.
Yeah, she's really good about that kind of stuff.
She's got all kinds of creations.
For some reason, they are not seeing that close-up. I'm clicking for them to see it.
That's weird. I'll try it from my window.
Yeah, let's try it one more time. We're going to try it one more time.
That's the close-up. I'm thinking of doing some buttons now, too.
Oh, that'd be cute.
Are they seeing it now?
We'll know in a second.
In the meantime, I'll just keep playing.
just keep putting buttons and stuff on there and playing. Yes. And
they saw it that time.
And yay! Sorry.
Mine is a real quiet craft.
I'll try and not be quiet. Did they like it?
Yeah, they were even asking for you to take a picture and upload it to Facebook.
Okay.
Okay, they see it now. Okay. They see it.
Yay! So I think I'm going to glue these buttons on because I didn't bring sewing stuff, but I can go back in and sew my buttons on later, because that's the good thing about gluing.
So is that paint that you use, is it drying already? Because it looks like it's dry. Okay.
It's getting there. It's kind of damp, but it's not transferring to me.
Okay.
Only the mess I made on myself
earlier. Is there a certain kind of paint that you're using that makes it dry that quickly?
It's just a fabric paint just from Plaid. Yeah. Paint?
Okay.
Fabric paint from Plaid. Maybe I'll put buttons like in each of my swirls.
Ooh, that would be cute.
My glue is stuck. This is not my day, Terry. I tested it before the show too.
Usually in a fabric tech, which I don't know if we have any up in the cupboard or not.
There we go. I got it.
It's typically.
Are they seeing the ground again?
Now it's only really picking up your laptop.
I don't understand. That is so weird.
You haven't done anything different than
what you should do. I have no idea. I mean, I normally control it, but you have camera rights too, so I have no idea. That's so funny. Oh, buttons. Buttons and fabric paint and embossing folders and stitching and
wool felt and denim and fun. Wow. This is, I don't know, does anybody else think that when you're stitching in that it's just relaxing?
I think
I'll just stay in here and stitch all day. What do you think, Kelly?
Nice.
What is it called? Cathartic?
Yes, cathartic. I'm actually taking half of today off. So I'm back from my whirlwind trip, and I'm like, I would like some time. Mm-hmm. Some me time. But then I get to come back for a meeting at 3. So just the afternoon. It's an afternoon.
It's an afternoon. A little siesta.
Yes. But we all meet sometimes.
Yes. So what has everybody else been working on? Any kind of fun crafts that you would like to share with us that you've been creating with Spellbinders products? Anything out there?
I see them all over the place.
I know. They're just like, is Susie on today?
I don't see Susie on.
She's
yet.
Not on today. She is busy. I know Chris has been busy. And Barbell also.
Yeah, they're all on here too.
Regina.
Regina's always busy.
Yeah, Regina's on here.
Yeah, we have been seeing a lot of really interesting stuff showing up lately with the new release.
Yeah, fun.
And now that the new Dye Delights are out, I'm kind of interested in, we'll see another little info.
Oh, yeah, probably so. I mean, crazy.
We have next week is scheduled for Stacy to be on Try It Tuesday,
sharing
how to expand your current dye collection.
Cool.
And we'll be talking about enhancing elements.
Oh, I love the enhancing elements.
Okay, Kelly, you've inspired Bear Bell to put her jeans in the Grand Caliber.
Yay!
And she was saying that she has cut so many different felts, and she thinks that the quality of the felt must be different because she's having to try out different material, I guess, because it's not cutting correctly. Because that was what I was wondering with the felt. Does it leave like the little stringy?
Not
wool felt.
Okay, wool felt.
Wool felt doesn't leave the little.
Maybe that's the difference.
If you're using just a regular felt that you can buy, like in your big box store, it's going to fray and it's not going to cut properly.
Okay.
And it's a softer, where a wool felt is more sturdy and it's really hardy. And typically you need to go to a fabric store or a quilting store to find the wool felt.
Also, we now have out our metal...
The shim.
Shim.
Mm-hmm.
And our metal shim will give you a lot more freedom in the fabrics that you're cutting as well. So if you were having trouble with certain kinds of fabrics, you might try our new metal shim because it cuts things like butter.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I mean, all sorts of stuff. I cut denim all the time with it and do.
So the metal shim is like a godsend if you're into cutting funky materials.
Mm-hmm. So did you get your stuff glued on, Kelly?
I did.
So what else are you going to add to it?
I don't know. I kind of like them how they are.
I really like them.
Now, whose pair of shorts are those? Are those Rachel's or Allison's?
They're Rachel. My older one is like a string bean. I got it.
Mm-hmm. I'm just doing that just to be on the safe side this time.
Yeah, my my little Rachel, she's a string bean. She's 9, and she wears like a 6 or a 7.
That's funny.
I know. They're so fun. I just love that at the bottom there.
That is cute. Very cute. And what did the paint say on it for your care for the jeans and stuff after you've done that?
That's a good question.
That is a good question.
So you would hate to go through all of that?
It doesn't say. So I'm going to Google it for you. And I will put it up with the picture. And that way we will know.
Yes. That is cool.
Oh, I didn't put it back. Sorry.
Okay. And you know what? It may pick it up. I just want to be on the safe side. So.
Yeah.
Such an odd day today. I think I'm in vacation mode for my half day already.
Oh, my goodness.
When you asked about what people projects they were uh-huh. working on, so Shirley was saying, Shirley is the one who has the large collection.
Yes, hi Shirley, I'm right there with you, girl.
She spent 2 days cropping Friday and Saturday, 12 Ooh. Hours each, and
Yay.
Made a mini album using Spellbinders dyes for embellishments.
Wow. Ooh,
yeah,
very
we actually
awesome.
Showcased the mini album on the blog this week. And we shared it on Facebook. So Shirley, we would love to see a picture of it.
Awesome.
And Shirley also started on Christmas cards. She was busy.
Oh. I crafted all weekend as well. But
so I did I. I'm just kidding.
But I can't tell you what I made. So
right.
I'm sorry.
Is it a surprise?
Yeah, okay. It's something for work.
Okay.
I did 4 projects. They were all very
tough
time.
Secrets.
Yeah, very, very labor intensive. And it involved sewing, actually, too. I was getting my craft on with sewing and stitching and all sorts of stuff. And it was lots of fun. And my dyes and all sorts of stuff. So I was busy, actually, since Thursday working on stuff. And then I also was working on, I'm going to be a guest designer for Just Right.
Yay!
Congratulations. October, I think, 13th, 14th, and 15th.
Cool.
So, and I'm going on vacation on the 10th of October, mm-hmm. so I have to get all my projects done for that. So...
That's
I was
exciting.
I was totally ecstatic when Kelly asked
yay,
me.
Yay,
so.
Yay. That's awesome.
Okay, I finally finished sewing the flower on here. Oh, look at you. That's cute. Kelly, I knew you weren't done with those. I knew you were going to go back in and dabble on those pants because I knew I would. Okay, yes, it takes a while to get this done, but the results are really, really phenomenal. And, what I have some pearls at home, just like I did on the other one here. This one here, the swirls and that. I'll probably take it home and add a few more swirls and some hand stitching with different colors. And then I will actually, like I had it laid out here. Can you see that? Sorry, Kendra.
Yeah. I just want them to see.
I'm not going to stitch the rest of this on because it takes quite a while to do that, as you can tell. But I will go back in and I will stitch these on here. And I'm actually making these for our Julian's in our shipping department has a little granddaughter. And so I'm going to finish these pants and give them to little Allie here. But I'll go back in and add some pearl swirls just like I did on this one. And I'll probably put a button in the center of these, like Kelly's got little buttons on her jeans.
I went back and painted a flower.
See? Cool.
Yay.
See, all the there's so many different things you can do with these and do that it's repurposing is so much fun. And sometimes it's time, sometimes it's time consuming, but it's well worth it when you upcycle something. But that has a lot of depth in it.
It yeah. really does. That's I'm wondering really awesome. If they were like starched.
If they would stay.
Yeah, that was the question someone was asking. If you thought that once you wash them, is the embossing going to stay in the pants?
I don't know. I don't know. I really don't. With the paint, you would think that it might.
Yeah.
Leave some sort of impression. I think if I might have starched them to begin with and then heat set it, like Terry said.
Right, it might have.
And maybe add some like glitter accents, glossy accents or something.
Something
just
that
to
would,
make it even
right.
more stiffen it up.
Well, they have fabric paint that actually has the glitter in it. So
yeah, that's true.
I think like your tulip or even Deco Arts, they all have some kind of fabric paint that has glitter in it. Even plaid probably has it too. So you'd probably be able to do that, and then you might not have the raised impression, but you will have the impression from the folder.
Right.
And that will give it dimension.
Right. Yeah. So anyway, that was really fun.
That's something to try. Any questions on how to do fabric and how to do...
Yes. Are the pearl swirls and iron-on applique that you use?
No, it's all hand-stitched.
Okay, it's all hand-stitched.
Yeah, it's actually, you can see, I'll show you the back of the pants. It's all the reverse side. It's all hand-stitched. Every pearl, everything is hand-stitched.
I have paint on me.
So, no. And these are actual, just...
like little seed pearls.
Yeah, they're all different kinds of pearls. And then everything is... this is all just done in an embroidery stitch. And even the May Arts ribbon flower here is actually also sewn on. So every bit of it is hand-stitched on. Which is kind of fun and cool and, you know, something different.
Yeah.
And I will do this and finish this off, and hopefully in a couple days I'll finish it, and I'll put a picture of it on Facebook because I got to bring these into Julie to give to Allie. So
cool.
But hopefully this inspires you guys to upcycle a pair of jeans, or you know, if not for your child, maybe even for you. Barbell will be waiting to see what you do with your jeans. Because we know you're going to go out and do something with them.
Right. You know she is.
So, any other questions about doing the fabric or anything?
I don't see any.
Okay. This was fun.
Something different. I'm,
something
you know,
different. We
talked about cutting different materials and stuff with our dyes and that. And this is just one more thing that you can cut with your dyes. And you've seen how easy it was.
Right.
I mean, it was like butter.
That was one way to use Rose Creation.
Yes.
Because normally we layer them and stack them and fluff them. And
right. And I don't think I would want that
right,
here because it's something
no,
flat.
I
it's already got
it's
enough
so
dimension.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's way cute.
Definitely.
Yay.
Okay. Well, do you have any announcements or anything, Kelly? You said Stacy's going to be doing Try It Tuesday next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday we have Stacy with Enhancing Elements, Expanding Your Dye Collection.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure who's going to be her co-host yet. Yeah, we are so very busy in our product development area. So
yes.
If you want to check the blog, We have our Emmy wrap-up post.
Yes.
So you can check out our pictures from Emmy weekend. Very exciting stuff there. And I believe we have some contest winners and things coming in, too. So
awesome.
Yep.
Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Yay!
Yay! Well, I guess we are going to wrap this up for today. Thank you guys for tuning in with us today. And look for Kelly's picture of her painted pants, right? That's what you call them, painty pants on Facebook. And I will finish these up and post them in the next few days on Facebook. And we will, I won't see you next Tuesday, but Stacy will be here, and we will be doing another Try It Tuesday on Tuesday. And thanks, guys, for joining us today, and we will see you guys next Tuesday. Bye. Have a great week. Bye.